Greetings, Earthlings. Welcome back to Podcastage Deuce. I am back with another test for a Podcastage YouTube member. Today, this request comes from Meditinsky, and he asked me to compare the SM58 and the Samson Q2U in an untreated room, and that is what I am doing. I am recording this in my living room, which has absolutely zero audio treatment, and I am about 3 inches off of the SM58 and the Samson Q2U connected directly to the Focusrite 2i2 second gen. The input gain for the SM58 is set just above 3 o'clock, while for the Samson Q2U we are at about 2 o'clock or 2:30. And I will leave a portion of this video completely unprocessed, but for the remainder I will completely level match them so you can get a good understanding of how they perform in terms of tone and room noise. And I suppose that I should go ahead and give you a quick clap so you can hear what kind of reverb each of them pick up. And now I'm about 6 to 9 inches off of the microphone, which some people may be doing when they record. Obviously, I do recommend getting a lot closer to the microphone to improve the signal to room noise ratio. But if that's not something you're going to do, this may be what kind of sound you're getting out of the microphone. So, okay, Bander from the future here. I did have to change my beanie, and while I was editing, I thought I would share some of my thoughts on this comparison. First off, in terms of tone, the SM58 does sound more nasally due to the presence boost that that microphone does have. That does have a benefit if you're trying to make your microphone cut through a mix. But if it's on its own and if the person speaking has a more nasally tone to their voice like me, it may not be the most flattering. The Q2U, on the other hand, has quite a bright tone, like they have a boost in the treble and air frequencies, which is unfortunately not shown on the frequency response graph that they provide, but it does give you a crisper tone and it avoids some of that nasaliness that the SM58 did demonstrate. So again, that would be personal preference if you want that crisper tone, but that may lead to a little bit of sibilance issues. And then as far as the room tone or how much reverb they picked up, I do think that they were fairly comparable. The SM58 did sound like it picked up just a little bit more when I was doing the clapping test. The Q2U, on the other hand, reduced a little bit of that reverb and room noise. However, as I said, I do think they are pretty comparable, especially when you get closer to the microphones within a couple of inches and really improve that signal to room noise ratio. Okay, future Bandrew done. Let's go back to past Bandrew and let him close out this dang video. There it is. Very brief, very straightforward test. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Which of these two microphones did you prefer the tone of? Yes, the Q2U does require slightly less gain, but do you prefer the tone of the Q2U over the industry standard SM58? This has been Bandrew reporting to you from NASA headquarters, not my living room at all. Why do you have a NASA flag in your living room? I don't know. Good question. Why are you asking such difficult questions? That's going to be it. If you have any tests that you want me to run, you can do so by becoming a member of the Podcastage YouTube channel. I will throw a link in the description down below. I will see you all next time. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And thank you for your support. Meditinsky. I think I am pronouncing that correctly. See you later. Bye.